Okay, Shalom. Okay, I'm just going to go over some pictures. I'm aware that some people live in the cities and it may not be possible to observe what has been lately the busy heavens. Okay, there's a lot of action, and I want to share what some of the images I've captured with everyone that may not have an opportunity, whether they be at work or, you know, whatever the case may be. So, I've just been taking pictures throughout the day. I've just been using the same method, sticking my hand up in the air and taking some shots. And a lot of good stuff has been popping up, as you can see already. Okay, just like May, June is going to be very, very busy. Starting, this video may not be out on time, but there's going to be a partial lunar eclipse tonight, as a matter of fact, in an hour, I think. And so I hope you all were aware of that one. I actually wasn't until right now. And tomorrow, June 5th, the transit, Venus is going to make a transit. It's a rare occasion. It doesn't happen very often. As a matter of fact, it's a very rare occasion. And the last transit that Venus made was 8 years ago. But that was because whenever it happens, it happens in pairs. And so it'll make a Venus will, well, first let me explain what's going to happen. Venus is going to pass, not over, but pass through the sun, and we're going to be able to see a round object. Oh, well, Venus's shadow on the sun. Sorry about that. Well, this was a really interesting picture. Also, if you can, don't miss that one. Oh, and it's interesting because so 8 years ago it happened, Venus did a transit, and now it's gonna do the second and last one for a very long time. There's so much going on. I'm just trying to get through the pictures real fast. Oh, this one's a good picture. This is the moon. I think it was a three-fourths moon or something. But I see, I'm not going to go into detail, but there's a lot. There's no empty space, and I'll try to explain that a little better right now. Well, it turns out that most of these images have all the planets. Jupiter is visible at dawn when the sun is rising. Venus is going to be right in back of that. Saturn, it turns out, it's visible, which explains a lot. I kind of knew it, but I guess I played games and kind of made myself make believe that I didn't have a very good idea of what was going on. Yeah, I want you to get that. Well, yeah, you could kind of see that. Well, anyways, okay, so Jupiter's out there, Saturn's out there, Venus is out there, Mercury's is going to be out there on June 7th. It's going to begin to make an appearance. I think it was this, well, what I can't explain are those little dots, but when I was meditating upon some of these images, I was in a higher state of mind, right? And I clearly saw if the moon was a stargate, and then you had the little angels, climbing up the pyramid or Jacob's ladder and ascending and descending. And then all of these images, I recommend that you try it. I've been using, I don't have a camera or for pictures. I've been using my phone. My phone is not a highly advanced, you know, one of those iPhones. It's just a regular, like, low-budget phone. But it seems to be doing very well. Try it. I've even stuck my camera up in the air in the dark sky, and so there's no images captured. But as soon as I enlarge the images on the computer, there's no empty space. There's so much out there, and I'm not talking about physical things. It's more of a, I guess, spiritual consciousness type deal. It depends how open you are, but I've seen His Majesty on every image. The conquering lion is out there. Like, you gotta remember the sacred geometry. You know, if everything's one, then everything's one. And so everything's made up of geometric figures, right? And so everything is visible within those figures. I think I have an idea that the images that are manifested to each individual, I think, has to do with the state of mind those individuals are in, if they're even able to have images manifested to them. But yeah, very interesting. I've seen a lot of things in these pictures. It's just, it's mostly about just focusing, meditating, and just like, yeah, I guess you could say use your imagination. We've been told that's not good or wrong or whatever, but that's all nonsense. Our imagination is what creates reality. So yeah, tough. That's sad how kids are told, just like we were, that daydreaming and all of that is nonsense. It's really not. And so, more pictures. Oh, this one I actually just took today. So, this one right here, look. This one right there. Let me try to zoom in, but it's Saturn. I could definitely tell. I could see the rings from here. Yeah, it's quite visible, I would say. And then that lining up of planets, yeah, everything seems to point into that direction. These are wonderful times. Things could be better. And we're blessed to be able to experience such sights. You know, another thing that I and I Rastafari are going to have in common regarding experience that not many people ever will have. We get to witness a lot and a lot of truth, which is fantastic, I would say. I guess I'll mention that I'm really stoked, proud, happy. A lot of brethren and sistren are doing a lot of good stuff. Rastafari provides the best talent, and I know many have been doing so much. And I just want to let all know that, yeah, like, I mean, keep up. No contribution is too small for the well-being of the kingdom of His Imperial Majesty. One, Haile Selassie. Yeah, but we still got a lot to do, right? But yeah, have fun while doing it. Now, let me just... give me 1 second, please. Okay, so... oh, Mars is out there, too. Like I mentioned before, you can find Mars. Mars was actually right on Leo. It was one of the legs or the chest, but now it's
it's been moving eastwards, and Mars is, it's still in southern Leo. Oh, and, okay, so Saturn is in Virgo. Jupiter is in Taurus. And, oh yeah, and the, on the 19th, new moon, it's gonna be like a rare alignment where the moon is gonna be exactly in between and aligned perfectly. Well, the moon is gonna be aligned perfectly in between the sun and Earth, and the moon will not be visible on Earth. I'm not too well studied on astronomy, but I thought the new moon wasn't visible anyways. So I don't know how to explain that. I guess it's visible in some places, and in this alignment on June 19th, I guess it's not going to be visible at all, or something like that. Oh, Neptune is in Aquarius. Neptune, I guess it's visible. I think you have to use a telescope for that. So it's in the Water Bearer. And, okay, that about sums that up. And I guess I'll just mention, okay, some of these images, I'm not gonna go back to them, but it's funny because we were driving and on our way to work, and I live in a valley. It's very flat, I guess. And as I was driving, and we're on a highway, so it was going pretty, the car's going pretty fast, and at least 60, 65 miles per hour. And when I took the picture, I guess the sun was rising, it was like, I don't know, 5:30 a.m. And the image created like a warp. Well, I might as well just go to, like, it warped everything, like space, like the light warped, I guess, space. I don't know how to explain that. You see this? You see how it's, well, let me get the light. You see how it's, well, it's not that clear. Let me try to fix that. Well, you can see the road, but it's not curved like that. And like I said, the Imperial Valley is pretty much flat, but so I thought that was interesting. And I guess I'll just, last note, if you don't believe that there's a lot of manifestations in these images, there really is, because I remember a video on the Twin Towers where they're falling and there's some demons. You can see some demon like faces within the clouds. And I'm sure all of you can already see like different kinds of like, people would say illusions or whatever, but no, it turns out these things are real. See, I guess I'll just express my opinion on this. Like the nature and the origin of the event or the action taking place, I think kind of incorporates a lot of manifestations regarding, well, the origin of the birth of certain events. Like in this case, it was one plantation being set on fire so that they could quickly plant some other crop, and not even allowing the ground to rest and stuff like that. So it's pretty evil and wicked, and so I could understand how the origin of this action was negative and negative or scary, spooky, demonic figures can appear because of the origin of and nature of what's being manifested, and which plays a role, which led me to accept that the consciousness, you know, everything's consciousness, and so depending where your conscious is at, it's what you're gonna get. Like, so I admit that I can see some devilish figures, but then I could also see expressed upon these images
his majesty and more positive images because of the state of mind. You know, if you're dwelling in fear, then you will be open to manifestations of low frequency and like low level vibrational appearances, fields, and manifestations. You know, whatever words you want to choose to describe it. Same deal. Now, I believe that sums it up. Well, let me just give an example. Like, if someone's talking about someone and then that certain person, his conscience is kind of like, he knows he's been talking bad about some certain person, and then he hears his name, and then all of a sudden he gets all defensive, like, oh, I didn't say that, or whatever, all, like, why are you guys talking about me? And it turns out that it had nothing to do with him in that manner. And so it's his guilty conscience, as His Majesty says, that when it comes to spiritual ideals, and it's the conscious plays a large role.